we have been having meetings at all odd hours and some planning going on, like, I want to tell you, if you ever have a chance to go on a golfing weekend at Georgetown, do it, because it's so great when at 2:30 in the morning, they tap you on the shoulder and say, get up and come out in the other room, we've got it. Next day, I think it was later than that, a little later than that. No, seriously. You all know the situation in, what's been going on in Grenada, and concerns that we've had for a long time about that whole country, the Cuban connection. On October 12th or 13th, to keep things straight, Bishop Ryan was put on house arrest. Then a crowd estimated 10,000, which is one-tenth of the whole country's population, arrived at that house in support of him, and that crowd was fired upon by the people who had arrested Bishop. They are really leftist thugs. And they took him and his cabinet prisoners. They later executed him and several of his cabinet members. They fired into the crowd. They killed people, including children. There is the only semblance of law on the island is a 24-hour curfew with orders to shoot on sight. Now, we have about 1,000 Americans there. Several hundred of them are in the St. George Medical School. They're medical students. They have been confined to the school by the authorities for safety because of this curfew. The Grenada and five other countries in the Eastern Caribbean are members of a thing called the Organization of Eastern Caribbean States. And they met several days ago, or maybe they've been meeting longer than that, with the exception of Grenada, because it has no government to speak of. These nations then appealed, all of them are former colonies of Great Britain. They then appealed to Jamaica and Barbados to join them with whatever military forces they could put together to restore order and to protect their own people on the island of Grenada. Before this ever happened, and before we ever knew that anyone else was interested in this, we had a force, the rotation force of Marines, on its way in a flotilla of ships to Beirut. We had diverted that, turned that task force flotilla to go into the area and simply stand by someplace within immediate range in case we had to make an immediate evacuation of our Americans. But on October 23rd, we got a request from the OECD, a request, it was an urgent plea to join them because these countries have lived so peacefully. One of them doesn't have any military, two of them don't have any military at all, and the others just have a few. But they had joined together, as I say, asked these other two, and then this group, OECD, plus Jamaica and Barbados, made this urgent plea to the United States to join them in a joint effort to restore order to Grenada. You can find this hard to believe, but with all of these early morning meetings and everything else, we have managed to keep one thing in the administration from leaking. And at 5:15 this morning, the joint force landed at two spots on Grenada. Paratroopers in the south, Marines and other multiple force in the north, secured both airports. They're 8 miles apart, the one at the south tip of the island and then the operational one, the one that the Cubans have been building is up further north. Both airports are under our control. We have secured the school for the safety of the people. There is now firing and combat going on. There have been casualties. They've been evacuated to the USS Guam. I'm going to see if we've got any update on reports here in a minute and have others talk to you. But it was our feeling in making this decision, and believe me, it wasn't easy, and certainly in the face of what had happened in Lebanon, to order a thing of this kind. But first of all was our consideration for our own people. And second was, once this urgent plea had come to us, none of us believed that there was any way that the United States could say no to that without, in the eyes of the world, revealing that when the chips were down, we backed away. And I don't know what credibility we would have in the Middle East or anyplace else if we had done that. We believe we've taken the right action. We hope we'll be shortly out of there. But that, all the way to the operation just a short time ago, I appeared before the press and the chairman of the OECD, Mr. Charles, is also the prime minister of, I say Dominica and she calls it Dominica. But anyway, she is here and she appeared with me before the press a short time ago in her own explanation. These people, this was done legally in connection with the treaty. The OECD, all of them having been freed as colonies at the same time, have a treaty of mutual assistance to each other. And they think of themselves as relatives, as they're all the same people and under these different titles on these different islands. And it was on this basis that they took the action that they took. And I'll probably think of some other things I wanted to say, but I better turn it over now. Where's Bud? Bud's here, and Cap's here, and George is here. And is the general here?
New York City Marathon.
Yeah.
First we have here Mr. Fred LeBeau, who began this whole race and put it on. Next is John Paul Cruz.
Yes, hello there. Well, by golly, listen, I have the greatest admiration for what you did.
Thank you.
It just was wonderful to see you. You've done a lot for a lot of people.
And I'll keep it up.
Good.
Thank you.
And now Mr. Rod Dixon, who won the men's division.
Yes, hello there.
I do.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank you. It's, unfortunately, it wasn't American this year, but it's nice that somebody else from another country can, because I'm the first foreigner to ever win it, so we've had a good monopoly on that. And we took your cup away from you.
For us sending cups someplace out of the American Cup.
Down under, yes.
Well, it's just fine.
Thank you very much.
What it means at all, puts it together.
Yes, it certainly does, and it's. I love your country, and it's. I think it's just one of the nicest stays I've ever had. So exciting. They're great countries, and the people in New York are fabulous people, in spite of what everybody says about New York. They have their heart in the right place.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Next, Mr. President, we have Greta Waitz, who you met last year, because he keeps winning this event.
Well, they better stop eating like this. Totally different. Well, congratulations again.
Greta's husband, Jack.
Hello.
Wait a minute, Greta. Greta. I think we ought to have a family picture surrounding the winner.
We have one more in the family, actually. We have Greta's brother, John.
Oh,
what
well.
Do we have him to do? We'll get a picture now with you and the winners.
Oh, all right.
Excuse me,
yes.
Sorry.
Great inspiration to other handicapped people.
Fred, why don't you get yes. join?
One with Fred here?
Yes.
Fred's the only non-looking runner. All the others look like athletes.
Thank you, Mr. Fred.
That's great.
I wonder very much.
I'd just like to present the president a training for the New York City Marathon T-shirt for next year.
Well,
thank you very much.
I'm very honored and pleased to have this. I was just thinking.
Mr. President,
we
might have done that one more time.
We were on our way out when that happened there. Can we get the winners in here for once? There we go.
Thank you, sir. I used to run the 440 yards, which I guess is now called mainly the 400 meters. And along about the 300 mark, I used to think that I'd never finish. I just can't fathom 26 miles.
Always seems like someone's moving the finish line back as you get closer to it.
Yes,
right. Yes, I was hoping they would move it back because I could see that I may not make it in time. I made it with 385 yards.
Well, congratulations to all.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you.
And you are very successful here.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Very much.
Thank you.
Now we get a picture of your White House staffers that successfully completed this race. Rick? Mr. President, Rick Neal?
Oh, Mr. President.
How are you, sir? Fred Ryan? Okay, David. Let's make this group photo. Come on, David.
Now.
I forgot my medal.
Thank you.
You stayed the course?
Twenty-six miles.
I didn't know we were doing anything around here to keep someone in condition for that, but it's great to see you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
He completed the marathon.
Really?
And when I shook his hand and took his arm, I know from evidently having all his life to be on those crutches, I was feeling an arm.
It's like embracing Strom Thurmond. Huh, Strom?
Well,
that's the chairman.
Getting a fine response from Grenada.
I'm glad to hear that. You wouldn't know it from the TV networks or the
people down home feel that's necessary on the right coast. They're concerned about Lebanon. It's not too favorable.
Well, you know, this is surprising when you get to the grassroots, because Bob Thacker, you know, told us yesterday that from Oregon, what he was hearing, the calls that were coming in were 10 to 1 favorable. On Grenada.
Oh,
man. But the Lord, the networks last night, to see them deliberately find all the people they could find who would complain. And then they threw poor Malcolm Wallop in there as the only voice that said a sentence of support. That was to prove they were fair. Well, I know what you're in here for in regard to the crime legislation. Our Baker told me that got the core issue on that, the core taken up. But I'd be glad to hear from you what we can
do. Well, the majority leader yesterday attempted to bring up the crime packages.
Have you ever seen the consul and CAC's office in the Pentagon? You've been over there to his office.
See who?
The office that CAC has in the Pentagon.
Oh, yeah. The cabinet buildings were built a long time ago.
Because I think that in today's climate, everyone would have been reluctant to be that extravagant.
That's right.
Those office suites.
Yeah.
They're really something.
The 8th floor of the State Department building shapes up as a nicer and nicer. The two rooms that are allocated for small reception and luncheons and stuff like that that I have just been restored by Conger and his taxpayer donation approach. And they're quite lovely. One is named for Madison and the other for Monroe, and they have period furniture. It's just stunning. So it's a great work that I'm sure you've seen that you go through before you go into that very large room where dinners and receptions are held. The large rooms are going to be closed, and that's